agent Tao.
Fee.
I hear you're having trouble estimating accurate rock strengths and identifying boulders on your bridge site.
It's a nightmare, and my team is working so hard they're starting to fracture under the stress. I'm looking for new approaches to measure rock properties in the field, but...
I'm guessing you're getting some resistance. They need direction, Tao, not just pressure.
But I don't have any answers to give them. I've assigned several people to do literature studies on cutting-edge new methods, but it just confused the issue.
Don't crowd the discussion with extraneous information, Tao. The answer's simple.
I don't get it, V. What's the angle?
Measurement while drilling, Tao. Measurement while drilling.
A lot of information can be obtained by the very equipment that is used to penetrate the ground. Whether soil or rock is being drilled for exploratory testing or for foundation construction, various parameters can be measured that relate to the effort needed to penetrate the material. Those data can be interpreted to understand better the engineering properties of the soil and rock. Measurement while drilling is a subsurface exploration method that provides continuous, real-time monitoring and recording of data during the drilling process. Sensors installed on conventional drill rigs measure and record parameters including torque, downward thrust, rotational speed, and penetration rate. The readout on the rig allows for real-time monitoring. Data generated are used to identify strata changes, material variations, and anomalies. This information can provide critical insights for foundation design and installation. Measurement while drilling does not require modification of the structure of the drill rig and does not interfere with the drilling operation. Measurement while drilling also can help refine measurement of depth with the use of depth sensors. Measurement while drilling can be very useful where sample recovery has been found to be poor, where rock coring does not give good information about the continuity of rock masses, or in very dense soils for which standard penetration testing provides limited information and cone penetration testing is not possible.
This is a mess. I can't tell from these cores whether we have boulders and floaters above the upper rock layers. I don't know how we're going to put together bid documents that mean anything to the contractor. The change orders could be astronomical.
In addition to down pressure, torque, rotation speed, and penetration rate, we can measure fluid pressure and fluid flow rate and really get a complete picture of the response of subsurface drilling. You can use this data to estimate soil and rock strength characteristics and to plan your deep foundation program. So don't give up yet. We'll get you some useful data and make sure your project doesn't have a bunch of back-end costs. Before we get going, we'll inspect the bit. It's really important to conduct regular observations on the drilling equipment since wear on a bit and other minor changes in the equipment have impacts on the data collected.
This is the first reasonable data we've gotten here down at the top of rock. There are boulders, but it looks like a relatively thin layer over the competent rock mass.
In the analysis phase, compound parameters or relationships between multiple direct measurements can be correlated to strength parameters for foundation design, such as unconfined compressive strength of rock and shear strength of soil.
This isn't new. The technology is used regularly for monitoring installation of drilled deep foundations. It's been used for exploration drilling mostly in Japan and a number of European countries since the 1960s.
In fact, measurement while drilling was recently standardized in Europe for exploration drilling under ISO 22476-15.
Now, let's review the benefits of measurement while drilling. Measurement while drilling is a useful tool that gives a continuous record of the drilling process in subsurface environments being explored. Factors involved in the drilling process, such as crowd, torque, penetration speed, rotational speed, and injection pressure, among others, are measured and used to make correlations to soil and rock engineering properties. Measurement while drilling can obtain data in materials where SPT and CPT are not appropriate or where rock coring gives incomplete information. In addition to rock and soil properties, data generated during drilling can identify strata changes, material variations, and anomalies. The information gathered can provide critical insights for foundation design and can give valuable insights into practical installation consideration for drilled elements.
So, Tao, are you going to be able to convince your people that this is the technology they need?
I have confidence now, Fee. Next time you turn around, they'll all be up to speed and this project will be back on track.